Okay, hello everyone, welcome back to Legend of Mana. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenral. And what I was going to do to start off this episode was to drop the SS Buccaneer down on the world map and check around to see if there are any quests for us this moment we go in there, because it's typically how things work in this game. But I think for now, we're just going to start this West, where Bud has been kind of sick, I guess. Yeah, I guess he is sick. He did say the usual lines, like, take me with you, I got some wicked spells to try out, and then he just fell back over. I guess he's trying to act all normal, but either way, yeah, we're going to see what's ailing Bud today. Bud, are you alright? Wow, ailing? Ail? Bud? Beer jokes, yay! Anyways, what's wrong? Shut up. I just feel weak, it's all. No adventures for you, better get back to bed. I'll be alright. But I'll take a break from adventuring for now. Oh, that's stutter text. Whatever's going on with that. Either way, Bud's ill right now. Wonder how we can cure him. Maybe we should talk to that fruit fortune lady. No. I guess we're getting the same thing here. No more adventures for you. Get back to bed. Okay, so, yeah. Let's go and talk to the fruit fortune teller lady, as Lisa suggested. And I suppose while we're out here on the world map, I'll just drop down the SS Buccaneer, because I did poke around a little bit off screen, and apparently there are no initial quests for us to start with. So this is the second to last artifact that we've got left, and we're placing it on the world map right now, because we're going to have to go here eventually for this particular quest. And since this is the last artifact, pretty much, I do want to at least show off the world a little bit. Just briefly. Yeah, we've got like a whole line of squares along this edge of the map that we haven't even used, and pretty much all the squares along this line of this edge of the map that we also haven't used. So definitely have more than enough space for everything. But then again, you kind of have to pick your square on the entirety of the world map, which we saw in the first episode when we were first getting started with, you know, building our world and all that. But beyond that, yeah, I think we're about ready to get going on some more quests. And just want to show off my world map. And of course, our last artifact is going to go right here, kind of in this empty spot here. So either way, I'm going to talk to that fruit fortune teller lady, and she's over here in Domina. Alright, and she's kind of in this marketplace. We've talked to her, I think, once before. But if we do this now, I think this is the only time we really need her for a particular quest. But either way, want your fortune told? Sure. 10 lucre. Saving for my retirement, so no. That's peanuts. All we gotta do is go out and get one little coin from killing one monster or something like that. And that's, once again, a weird way of telling fortunes. And she spins them round and round and round, and picks one out. It says, Cactus will save the sick child. Maybe you should squeeze his juice and have the kid drink it. I don't know if our little cactus friend is gonna be okay with that. But we're going to head off and see what we can do with Li'l Cactus, Lisa, and Bud in order to help Bud get over his illness. So I will meet you back at home. Honey, I'm home. Oh, it's just Lisa. Cactus upstairs got up and ran away. Li'l Cactus. Apparently a lot of people don't like this because you're basically sent around the world chasing after our cactus friend. I wonder where your cactus went. We should go look for him. Sure. Alright. I guess that means she's in my party? Okay, yeah. What happens if we talk to Bud now? Taking a few. Same thing as before. Okay. Talked to him a few times and saw that, I don't know how many times already. So, yeah, let's check the pot and see where he went. You find a note. Let's read it. I went to ask Gaius how to make potion. Alright, so, I guess that means we're heading off to the highway. So, I will meet you there as well. I guess we're going to do a lot of running around and cutting out today. And if I remember right, the first thing we should do once we get here, if we want to go to Gaius quickly, is to talk to the Boink. And he should teleport us like two screens away from where Gaius is. So, let's slaughter our way there, because if I'm not mistaken, these guys will probably just go down in one hit. Yeah, as to be expected. These guys are weak, since this is, once again, one of the first places we dropped on the world map. Anyways, let's keep on going. And once again, a chocobo is on the screen. I believe there is a way to get a chocobo pet, but you have to have, like, a Final Fantasy VIII save data on your memory card when you do that initial quest to unlock the monster corral. I just didn't have a Final Fantasy VIII save copied over because I didn't think that was a thing. Anyways, we're at Gaius, so he's like, once again, welcome my children, come closer. Okay. Welcome, Afonso. Your friend the cactus just stopped by to ask how to make a potion. I told him it's better to ask Silky about things like spells and potions. Oh, and Lisa's got a thing to ask for herself as well. My feet keep falling asleep on me. How can I fix it? It bothers me. My legs have been asleep throughout my 80 billion year life. Ain't no spring chicken here. But you're a rock. Rock's legs are always asleep, but we fear nothing. Yeah, but that's because... Oh, never mind. Bye now. Goodbye, my lady. You understand once you become a rock. I sure hope not. And again, my children. So I guess that was just some witty banter. But anyways, yeah. I believe chocobos are locked as kind of a pet that you can't normally get. Which is kind of explaining why I just kind of brought it up out of the blue. But yeah, apparently if you do the initial monster corral quest where... I believe we gotta beat Dwell, the little onion knight, over in the back end of Domina after you've done a handful of quests and learned how to catch pets. Or catch eggs, that is. Instead of just the... Was it the rabbit that we originally got? That's what you're supposed to get in a normal playthrough. But apparently, if you have a save file of Final Fantasy VIII on your memory card, it'll detect it. And when you do that quest with the well, just to get your monster crawl started, instead of it being just, I think, a normal beast egg that contains a rabbit, I think it'll be instead a bird's egg of some sort, and it'll actually contain a chocobo. So, I don't know if it's exactly a chocobo or a black chocobo, but either way, that's kind of a hidden thing in the game that apparently you can do if you want to get yourself a chocobo pet. And probably I think it's the only way they can do it as well. Anyways, let's kill some more of these guys. Good for seeds, after all. I just wish there was a more reliable way to get things like flattened spiny seeds, which I doubt these guys will drop. Maybe if I were to meet them in a high-level area, they might have better loot. But for the time being, we gotta head out and go speak with Silky, who I believe is that one penguin girl in the jungle. So I think at this point we're going to head out that way. And yeah, we've already been given the runaround already. But it ain't going to stop anytime soon. So you know what? Well, actually, I think we're pretty close to the exit, so we'll probably just talk this out and we'll head off to the jungle. And more fights. Yeah, they still go down pretty easy. In fact, you know what? I'm thinking. I haven't changed weapons in a while. I've been using my favorite two-handed sword, which is my favorite weapon type. But I think we'll switch over to something different today. Why not two-handed axes? they're basically the same thing as a two-handed sword. Actually, you know what? Since I doubt we're going to do any major quests for a while, I just want to get caught up on all these little side quests. Let's do something a little bit weaker. Let's go with fist weapons for the time being. And use that to learn some more skills. And we're going to avoid the boink because he'll teleport us back over to Gaius. Anywho, back on the world map. And I believe in order for us to get to Silky, once again, we got to go back over to the jungle. And warp over to that screen that has the other wisdom over here. So let's go. And up to the flowering. And to the ruins. And that should be where Silky is hanging out. Now that we've done the one quest where we've already met Silky and did that part for the Eskid Erwin Matilla quest line. Hehe, I'm like Silky. Nice to meet you. Li'l Cactus stopped by. He said a little sorcerer has fallen ill. The way he described it sounds like an illness all sorcerers get. I told him about Brownie, who just got over that illness. Okay, and just her normal dialogue. So, I think now we have to figure out a way out of this damn forest once again. And I will meet you at Geo, which apparently is where Brownie is supposed to be hanging out. I guess we've never met him, but he's one of the students, if I'm not mistaken. So, I'm hoping I can figure out my way out of this place without too much of a hassle. No, I don't want to hassle with some zombies. Let's go the other way. So, I'm probably going to wander my way outside of this place once again. So, I'll meet you once I navigate this maze of a jungle, and I'll meet you at Geo. And once again, we're in Geo, the place with the music from Super Mario RPG. And I'll actually let you listen to it again proper, because I swear it sounds like Moville. Now that I think about it, it might be a hybrid of Moleville and Mushroom Kingdom. But yeah, I've played enough Super Mario RPG to notice the comparison there. Either way, you also saw when we were in Geo that Lisa apparently knows the names of all the students. I think Bud does too, and I think that'll be important to a quest later. My memory's a little bit hazy on that one, but we'll get there when we get there. But this is our first time on the SS Buccaneer. And we gotta find a pirate named David. The same David from the similar loving quest that we met a little while ago when we went to the Medora Beach. Anyways, let's figure out which one of these is David. SS Buccaneers are pads. Speaking of pad, ever been to Mario's pad? I don't care about nothing no more. Alright. Have you ever seen David? We'll get to this guy later. I've been poking around in a few of the various guides, and apparently there are a bunch of quests related to that guy who amends the wheel of the ship. I want to become a real dandy like the captain. I actually read this off-screen. Speaking of off-screen, I actually talked to the captain here. If you ever want to leave, just talk to the captain. He'll ask, how's the ship? She's a beaut, ain't she? If you like, no. He'll be like, that's a shame. Well, we'll let you leave the ship. That's how you'll leave this place if you ever want to leave. Just gotta figure out where David is now, I guess. I don't exactly know where he's going to be, but... also, the rotation of the boat here, I think, is kind of poorly done there. Yeah, it's kind of weird graphics and all that. Again, this was PlayStation 1, so maybe that would be considered to be pretty cool on a sprite-based level? Or a pre-rendered background level? Not entirely sure, but they kind of just rotated the image a little bit as you go. Energy of the sea! What about the energy of the sea? Now, the SS Buccaneer is kind of a weird place. I'm not going this way. Because the thing about the SS Buccaneer is that there are monsters if you go too far below deck. So it's kind of like a weird hybrid between town and dungeon. Kind of like Gato Grottos, but the dungeon in Gato Grottos was this whole separate area off to the side. Anyways, we penguins, but we could be turning human. Okay, so pirate penguins once again. Kind of weird little jokesters for whatever reason. Alright, hatchway. Let's see what's in this other hallway. Because this place is mirrored a little bit, so... Boom! Yeah, I get it. We got cannons here, and you'll love yourself some firearms. Sometimes I miss swimming in the sea. Well, you could do that anytime you want, you know. Just make sure someone's gonna lift you back up. Also, don't get swept away, because the boat is moving at all times. And here's a save point if we need one. I don't see no David, though, so you gotta keep on looking to see where he might be at. Behind the staircase, maybe? If I'm not mistaken, there are monsters in this room. I do remember this place a little bit. Yeah, we've been this way before. Do you have to keep on going down? I'm not entirely sure where David is hanging out. But I think the more you go down, the more likely you are to find some monsters in some of these rooms. Pirate ain't supposed to fall in love, buddy. It sounds like David might be around. Ah, there he is. Li'l Cactus stopped by. Wanted a potion, so I gave it to him. I let take him home, but I don't know if they made it. If I'm not mistaken, that's the name of the post penguin, or not penguin, she's not a penguin. Pelican, that's the name of the type of bird I was thinking of. The postman pelican. Yeah. But either way, let's get out of here. Why not? Let's go and actually talk to the captain up on top deck. And we'll get to actually see what happens if you talk to the captain, because, well, I've seen it, but you guys haven't. So, let's go into the main hub here. Through the door with the double swords on the wall. And we should be in Captain's quarters. I'm Captain Tux, leader of the Empire Penguins. Well, how do you like the ship? Ain't she a beaut? Well, if you say yes... you got what it takes to be a man of the sea. But I'm playing a female protagonist. So you know what? I'll say no. That's too bad, Minnie. Let you leave the ship. Once again, that guy is the one we saw back when I think we were exploring Lake Kelma for the first time and fought that giant petrification eye thing. But anywho, we need to find the post lady, and we know she typically hangs around in Domino most of the time. So once again, we're taking a trip around the world in not by boat. Anywho, yep. We gotta go back to the outskirts of Domino, which is gonna be a few screens away, so I will meet you there. Alright, and as you can see, there she is. Little cactus hurt me, so sharp in the mouth. But you know what? My job is the mail, I put him in the box and I'm all done. Okay, yeah. She kind of sings when she does her job. I guess that's kind of like how it goes with the old mindset of whistle while you work. And I couldn't really do that on the fly. But anywho, yep, back home we go, and we should be able to find little Cactus, who is apparently not going to get his juices squeezed out today. He's actually found a potion for Bud, I guess. So, I guess that's where it all started, and back where it all began, we're going back there and going home. And we should be able to find little Cactus in the mailbox. Which is, in fact, by the way, now that I think about it, the mailbox is the artifact that we used to create our own house when we first started the game. Anyways, there you are, Li, you little pinhead. I see you there. I got potion. And there we go, that's it. I don't think there's a reward or anything for doing that, but that's the end of the quest. Just one big run around, and yeah, that's all she wrote, I guess, considering the fact that little cactus was male, apparently. Anywho, we're going to go back to the little cactus once again, or Data as I like to call him. And we're going to, actually, you know what, he should be the one to report the quest to himself. But yeah, I think he knows this quest more than we do, considering the fact that it was his little quest instead of ours. We were just chasing after him the whole time. So, talk to him. Yeah. And it's quest number 49. Little cactus once again. Finally, I got to go on an adventure on my own. Green balls, taco bugs, I will never forget your smiles. I feel like I saved the world today. Just feeling like that is enough for me. And again, I guess that might be why adventurers like doing what they do. Some might be in it for the money, but I think just the whole making the world a better place is what adventure is all about. Or just, you know, having fun and just wandering the world, I guess. Anyways, anything you got to say about that? No. Okay. No, I'm not going to bring you along. I'm done with you besides, because I'll take Lisa over Bud any day. Alright. Anyway, speaking of watching the fort and hanging around at home, I do want to take a look at something. Just because of the fact that I was using my two-handed sword for a while, and I wasn't learning any moves after a while. So, I think those are flail moves. Punching moves. I believe those are staff moves. Spear moves, I guess? Javelin, after all. Let's see here. I believe these are hammer moves. And these might be one-handed axes. And this. I believe these are my two-handed sword moves. And I kind of want to see if there are any major blanks around here. I'm not totally sure. Two-handed sword technique. So yeah, we kind of got a few more to learn. I think I should probably equip some more, you know, other abilities and just use them with my tuned sword next time I use it. But let's see here. I think I'm gonna be using fist weapons next, so we'll just see what we can learn right off the bat next time we get into a fight. But for today, well, that was a little bit of a long quest. I did do a little bit of cutting, but it has taken me half an hour to do. So, you know what? I'm going to call it a day here. And, we're going to save the game and finish up today's episode. So, this is SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Fenral, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.